So there are many factors that can hide behind diagnosis of unexplained infertility. And they break down into the same three sort of general topics that everybody does as part of the fertility workup. For instance, a lot of people will come and say they have a normal hysterosalpingogram, but it's very common for us to either repeat the hysterosalpingogram or review the images that people bring to us of their hysterosalpingogram and see that there actually is a problem. This is because many radiologists, while they're very good radiologists, aren't that used to dealing with fertility patients. And if they see dye go into the uterus and come out the tubes, they say it's normal. We look a little bit more carefully, try to see, is there any distension of the tube at all? Is there a jet-like stream of dye coming from the end of the tube? Is the dye accumulating in pockets around the outside of the tube? And these are all little hints that you can see that help you to understand whether the tubal anatomy is normal or not. Any abnormality of the tube that keeps it from being freely open to pick up an egg or to move around to be able to pick up the egg could interfere with the fertility process. So it's very interesting when we do a hysterosalpingogram, many couples will conceive in the month or so after we've done the procedure. And this is very common, suggesting that even when the study appears to be normal, you've actually flushed some small blockage out of the tube by the physical act of pushing the contrast media through the tubes. So that's one sort of general area having to do with tubal problems.